got a new bank up here.
I know.
You're special, you're to me like.
Getting that little deal out there, like that, aren't we?
Taxes, that's motivated, now they sure got more money in than expected.
We have a little tax revenue.
Yeah, we got more money revenue in than we expected, on account of the,
I didn't even read it all.
Yeah. I think three of them asked for that 1% increase, but we'll go to the teacher's supplement, that's it, that's nothing. But now I don't know.
It wouldn't look, but it finally did. I guess it's only.
Take off, I had a lazy day yesterday, church, I said. Yeah, I was watching ball games, I was in the bedroom, crawled in the bed, watched TV, I woke up.
Where do I go now?
I'm pretty good.
This is it, start right there.
I'm pretty good.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
It will just flip.
It will.
Yeah, I think so.
I didn't kiss. Yeah, I believe in.
Phil was here somewhere.
Hmm?
Phil was here somewhere.
Yeah, he's there. No, he's sitting out on the third row.
He's sitting up over here.
Third row on the left. Yep.
Boy, it'll hurt getting that.
I'll tell you.
Find her a couple times a day, but she ain't nothing at all.
Yes, I had to say one thing about him, he was a gentle, gentleman. Just very kind, compassionate. I hate to hear that. A young guy too.
How old is that?
Sixty, he's sharing his age, 65, 66. Born 48.
Born 48.
Mm-hmm.
You got two, I mean, one.
Yes, sir, one of them.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, let us all rise and we have invocation and the pledge.
Our fathers, we come together today. We come to discuss the finances of Nash County. We also come to discuss the financials of the other things that involve the county. God, we just ask each one of us to keep an open mind, God. Remember that we are to do your business first and the other things come second. God, just be with each one of us today and may we stop and think before we speak because sometimes we really don't do that. But God, we know that you are with us and you're going to be with us through this meeting. And we just ask you to guide and direct us in all the things we do that it may be right for the people of Nash County. All these things I ask in your blessed name. Amen.
Amen.
Place the flag, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. This is a recess meeting from our previous budget meeting, and I'd like to remind everyone that this is not a public hearing. We will have a public hearing first Monday, which is June the 2nd. And anyone that wants to speak at that time individually or as a group may do so. So we're going to try to finish up what we're going to recommend in the budget. And I'm going to call on the county manager to present the recommendation.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. Before you, you have a letter dated May 19th from myself and the staff regarding our budget proposal. And I'll read part of it and maybe paraphrase other parts. The recommended FY14-15 Nash County budget is presented for your consideration. The general fund budget, which includes our tax-supported governmental activities, is proposed to be $89,222,193, which represents a 1.61% increase over this year's adopted budget and a 1.24% decrease from this year's revised budget as it stands today. The budget provides sufficient funds to continue current service levels and requires no increase in any general fund taxes or fees. Moreover, the budget will maintain the county's healthy financial condition with an unassigned fund balance, which we believe by June 30th will grow to around 28% of our general fund expenditures this year. County revenues will increase by about $1.1 million next year, primarily due to additional ad valorem revenue collections, due to enhanced collection procedures and estimated increases as a result of the tax and tag implementation for motor vehicles, and projected increases in ambulance fee collections with the new billing model that the commissioners have adopted. Revenue categories are described in more depth in the narrative beginning on page 2 and in the budget summaries that follow. Highlights of the budget include ad valorem tax revenues reflect a 1.3% increase over the prior year due to modest tax base growth of $64 million and estimates for the motor vehicle taxes under the new system. We're anticipating an additional $1 million in ambulance billing revenues reflective of changes in the contractual arrangement, implementation of a new web-based software, and enhanced collection efforts. The budget includes a 2% across-the-board pay adjustment effective July 1 for all county employees. This is the first pay plan adjustment since FY07-08. In addition, a reserve for merit increases in the range of 0.75% to 1.5% is budgeted. You will find that there is no increase in the health and dental insurance that the county has to pay, nor any coverage changes. The good news is our cost to claims ratio is around 85%, which is right on par with the what a company would want to maintain. The self-insured plan has stabilized and the employee's health insurance reserve has been restored to about $750,000, with another increase projected this year. The $15 per month per employee contribution towards medical insurance costs continues for the coming year. The commissioners have set aside $250,000 for architectural services for the courthouse sheriff facilities renovations. We've added new positions in county government. One parks and recreation office assistant, which will replace a part-time position. One soil and water administrative assistant position, which replaces a part-time position. One sheriff's civil record specialist, which replaces a part-time position. And one new DSS child protective services agent, which is necessitated by the case volume that our current CPS workers are having to maintain. Six positions previously frozen during the beginning of the Great Recession are being eliminated from our books totally. So we're adding four full-time positions. We're eliminating six positions that are, have been carried but not filled for the last few years. The board has recommended a $100,000 capital reserve established for Nash Community College to deal with their HVAC and roofing issues. The hope is that that money will not have to be used this year, and it can start to build, and we can have a capital reserve for the community college. Second year funding of $125,000 for DSS in response to the ongoing NC FAST implementation. Also, first full year debt service for the community college GO bond in the amount of $762,170. In addition, this year's budget included, last year's budget, or the current year budget, included a $400,000 for the Nashville EMS station. That has not yet begun, so we are putting it in next year's budget. This FY 2014-15 budget is presented to you in accordance with the North Carolina Local Government Budget and Fiscal Control Act. The proposed budget is presented subject to a public hearing and the Nash County Board of Commissioners revisions and approval. This budget as presented is balanced. The total revenues and expenditures for the general fund are $89,222,193 compared to the original FY 13-14 budget of $87,805,377. The FY 14-15 budget as proposed is based on a 67 cent tax rate, the same as the current year. This represents the fifth consecutive year that the tax rate has not increased. This budget also does not increase water rates, solid waste fees, inspection fees, or any other county fees within the general fund. County administration received budget requests, revenue estimates, and other financial information from various officials, officers, department heads, and agencies of Nash County. The proposed budget is based on staff information and information provided by and input from the county commissioners. Each department or agency presented an original budget request to the finance office. Upon receipt, the county manager met one or more times with each department head to establish a budget to be submitted to the Nash County Board of Commissioners. Subsequently, the commissioners have preliminarily reviewed the budget. In the case of special appropriations requested by outside government agencies and nonprofit organizations, including the Nash Rocky Mount Board of Education and the Nash Community College Board of Trustees, the recommended appropriations reflect the result of budget work sessions involving the Board of Commissioners and staff. First, I'll talk a little bit about revenues. Our property tax collections, that projection for next year must be based on the last audit, the FY 12-13 audit. That year, our total tax collection rate was 95.51. Already through 10 and a half months of this year, we have reached 97% as a result of the hard work by the tax office. So in future years, we'll have that benefit, and it also allows some money that we can anticipate without putting it in tax collections, but feel comfortable when we start appropriating from fund balance. FY 2014-2015's estimated property tax revenues for real property is calculated upon the audited tax collection rate for real and personal property only of 97.06%. That was last year's. And that's excluding motor vehicles, which was around 81.95%. So you join those together and you get the 95.51. But just real property, personal property, public utilities, that's 97.06%. So that's the amount, that's the percentage we're using to calculate our real and personal property revenues for next year. This year is a little different than normal years because under the new tax and tag provisions for collection of motor vehicles, estimating property tax revenues for motor vehicles is not as clear cut. The new method was implemented around October of this year. So in this year, we'll have some collections under the old system and now collections under the new system. Next year, it'll be almost exclusively under the new system. But based upon the State Treasurer's Office recommendation for estimating property taxes, we're estimating almost $4.2 million for the coming year. We feel that's a very conservative estimate. Last few months, we've collected over $400,000 each month, which puts us to the $4.8 million figure, but we use the methodology recommended by the State Treasurer's Office, and that was calculated to be $4,198,000. This still represents, even being conservative, a increase over what we collected last year by $372,000. So I believe the new tax and tag system, which is netting us about a 97% collection rate, the fees for credit cards and the vendor fees for the driving license stores, are costing us about 3%. So instead of 81.95 like we collected last year in vehicles, we can anticipate that in future years we'll collect a net of about 97% of the vehicle taxes after cost to the county. County staff is committed to increasing tax collection rate during future years. In addition, we will be focusing in future years more on collecting prior year delinquent taxes. I can tell you that the tax office is already, as I said, we believe the tax collection rate this year will be over 97, or it's already reached 97. We hope it'll get to 97.5%. We're doing several things. 2 weeks ago, the tax office compiled a list of the 25 top taxpayers owed the most money. We've cleared four of those 25 just in 2 weeks. So we're also doing garnishments. We're doing the debt set-off program. And we're also sending out letters urging people to pay their taxes. Next, the estimated tax base. This year's tax base is estimated to be about $7 billion, a 1% increase over the prior year. At 100% collection, each penny of the tax rate will produce about $700,000. The total tax valuation for real and personal property and public utilities is estimated at $6,288,000,000. So at 100% collection, you're looking at $628,800 per penny assessed. If you multiply that by the 67-cent tax rate, we're anticipating, just in real and personal and utilities, $40,892,000. As previously stated, motor vehicles we're estimating at about $4.2 million. which is effectively an 88% collection rate, again, based on the advisory sent by the State Treasurer's Office. Therefore, the FY14-15 budget anticipates collection of $45,090,000 in ad valorem taxes from real and personal properties, public utilities, and motor vehicles. This amount represents 52.86% of all general fund revenue. The FY14-15 budget also anticipates collection of about $1.35 million in prior year delinquent real and personal property and motor vehicle taxes, as well as $246,000 in penalties, interest, and other miscellaneous charges assessed upon delinquent taxes. So adding the next year's as well as prior years and penalty and interest together, the figure represents 54.73% of the general fund revenues. Regarding sales tax, Nash County anticipates collecting $5.279 million from the local option 1 cent Article 39 sales tax. That's the one, the point of sale, the original sales tax, which is 1%. The general fund also anticipates collecting a total of $2,469,000 from the half-cent Article 40 sales tax, which is based on per capita and spread across the whole state. An additional 30% of Article 40 sales tax is restricted for school capital projects and is used to cover school capital expenses. The county further anticipates collecting from the half-cent Article 42 sales tax a total of $1,403,000. An additional 60% of the Article 42 sales tax, which is point of sale, is restricted for school capital projects and also is used to cover school capital expenses, including debt service. Total amount of sales tax revenues anticipated in the general fund is $11,900,000. This amounts to 13.95% of the general fund revenues. The county will provide an estimated $2.749 million of Article 40 and 42 restricted school sales tax towards school capital outlay and school debt. The budget also anticipates $646,000 in other taxes and unrestricted revenues, miscellaneous. Health department, we're anticipating $6,003,135 in revenues. From state revenues for social services reimbursements, we're anticipating $10,190,767 in revenues. Other revenues that we have budgeted for next year include restricted revenues of $1.662 million. That includes $936,000 in lottery fund. We'll collect about $1.2 in lottery funds, but that is the cost of the debt service that we are using lottery funds for, is the $936,000. Permits and fees, $1,023,000. Sales and services, $4,877,000. Investment earnings, $130,000. And other revenues, $1.24 million. Which totals about $9.86 million. From fund balance appropriated, the total amount appropriated from fund balance is $3,926,908 from the following amounts. To balance the budget, $2,665,000. $125,000 for DSS NC FAST implementation. We're going to take from restricted reserves from the Health Department, 232,476, which is what you do every year. We're going to spend $53,000 for the Hospira inducement agreement. We'll draw down the remaining money from the wireline reserves of $2,163. And we will use $849,047 for county capital items, including the $250,000 for architectural services for the courthouse and sheriff office renovations, as well as for the $400,000 for the Nashville EMS station. The general fund expenditures overview, for general government, we're appropriating $9,704,431. That's for the overall administrative cost of county government. Public safety, $20,283,000. That includes the law enforcement, sheriff's office, jail, emergency services, animal control. Economic and fiscal development, $1,915,561. For the Health Department, expenditures in the amount of $9,720,506. If you subtract the revenues from that figure, indicates about a $3.72 million net expenditure for health services here in the county. For the Department of Social Services, we are expected to spend $15,897,576. If you subtract the revenues for social services from the state, it nets $5.7 million in county expenditures not covered by reimbursements. Also listed there are some other human service funding that we have in the amount of $1,940,384. That includes veteran services, aging department, juvenile justice, and other things that are highlighted in the budget. For cultural resources, libraries, parks and recreation, we're budgeting $1,640,243. For education, the FY14-15 budget includes $22,512,151 for Nash Rocky Mount Schools and Nash Community College. Nash Rocky Mount Schools' current expense and capital outlay are budgeted at the same levels as FY13-14. Nash Rocky Mount Schools' current expense, $19,175,161, will be funded monthly, 1/12 of that amount each month, and the capital outlay of $1,396,890 will be funded upon documentation of the capital expenditures, which is the way it's always been done. Lottery funds of $936,000, as well as restricted sales tax in the amount of $2,749,000, will be appropriated for school capital outlay and school debt that the county is currently covering in the amount of $3,353,514. Nash Community College will be funded at $1,645,000. It's a slight increase of $3,300 as a result of an agreement to provide funding for a state-maintained road, the roundabout, in front of the college, and also the $100,000 set aside for future capital needs. Capital outlay is budgeted as the same level for the community college as last year. However, debt for the new GO debt for the continuing education and public facilities building is a new expenditure in the amount of $762,000. Debt service, the amount of debt service paid by the county will be $5,452,538. That includes schools, community college, as well as lease purchase agreements involving the county. We will put $40,000 in a contingency line item, and we'll also put $115,000 towards our revaluation reserve, which has been underfunded up to this point. In addition to the general fund, the county administers several funds supported by fees or other restricted revenue sources. The utilities fund and the fire district funds are briefly mentioned here. Other funds are shown in the budget summary. The county utilities fund operates as an enterprise fund with no tax contribution. The water and sewer systems and our solid waste program that make up the fund are supported by user fees. Public utilities does not include any rate increase. An emergency town of Bailey water rate contingent on Rocky Mount approval and a bulk hydrant meter setup fee are included in the fee schedule. The solid waste program is composed of two elements, the C&D landfill and our convenience sites, both of which are operating at a deficit. The C&D landfill revenues have declined because of a drop-off in development in the county. Our current tipping fee is at a market rate, and any increase might drive haulers to competing landfills, reducing our volume even further. Based on the board's direction, no fee increase is recommended at this time. The county levies a tax in 18 fire districts throughout the county and administers the collection and disbursement of those taxes within the fire district fund. Four fire districts are requesting a rate change increase for FY 2014-15. Harrison District is requesting a 1 cent increase from 9 cents to 10 cents. Mo Meyer District is requesting a 2 cent increase from 6 cents to 8 cents. Middlesex District is requesting a 3 cent increase from 5 cents to 8 cents. And Salem District is requesting a 4 cent increase from 8 cents to 12 cents. Further explanation of the increases is provided in the Fire District Fund summary. A copy of the budget has been filed with the clerk to the board and is available for public inspection in the manager's office as well as on the county website. A notice of public hearing will be published in the Rocky Mount Telegram as well as the Nashville and Spring Hope newspapers. The same published statement will also give notice of the time and place of the public hearing during which any person who may wish to comment on the budget may appear before the Board of Commissioners and speak. No earlier than 10 days after today's date, May the 19th, the date of the formal budget presentation, and not later than July 1, 2014, the Nash County Board of Commissioners must adopt a budget ordinance making appropriations, estimating revenues, and levying taxes for FY 2014-15. This budget represents our best estimate of revenues and expenditures during the coming year. As with any budget, during the course of the coming year, fiscal year, adjustments may be required to amend the adopted budget. The Nash County Board of Commissioners is required to approve any such budget adjustments which increase or decrease a department's total expenditures during the course of the fiscal year. I urge the commissioners to carefully consider and study this proposed budget. If there are any questions or concern, please do not hesitate to contact me on behalf of your county staff. And I would like to point out the great job that our finance director and our assistant county manager and all the department heads have done helping in the preparation of this budget. The entire finance office has really done so in a very professional and just a super job they have done. And I just would like to mention those people. But on behalf of them and myself, we look forward to working with the commissioners during the coming year to provide the best services possible at the most reasonable cost to the taxpayers of Nash County. Mr. Chairman, that's my preliminary budget message. I mean, that's my formal budget message. I will point out that the next few pages in your material is the budget ordinance, and I would like to bring to your attention section 19, since it is a new section. Let me see here. Yeah, section 19, Roman numeral XX1, 19A. This is new language that the finance officer and the assistant county manager, speaking with our county attorney as well as folks at the Institute of Government, wanted to have clarification on the county manager's authority to execute contractual documents. The law allows up to $500,000. The staff is recommending $200,000, but I just wanted to point that out to y'all because that's new and you may want to go higher or lower, and just wanted to make sure y'all were aware of that new provision in the budget ordinance, which will be adopted after the public hearing, either immediately or any time prior to July 1. If there's any questions, I'll be glad to answer them. We would recommend that a public hearing be set for June the 2nd at our regular meeting. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for presenting the recommended fiscal year 14-15 budget. Any questions or comments from any commissioners?
Could, Mr. Chairman, if I may, could you elaborate on why we would be making that change from the half million to the 200,000?
What brought
it up, et cetera?
I think I inquired about my authority, and so they looked into it, talked to the Institute of Government, talked to Vince, and I'm not sure there was any authority in the actual prior budget ordinances.
It wasn't to my knowledge.
It was nothing in there. And looking at the statute, it allows up to a half a million, but we had to pick a number and ended up at the 200,000.
Mm-hmm. And note that it does say that it has to be within budgeted departmental appropriations, so it would have to be something that you all had already approved in
sure.
the budget.
Yes. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any other comments from any other commissioners? I have some myself I want to make. And looking at listening to the budget, and I had proposed part of this in the earlier budget hearing, that we increase the school budget at least by 1%, and you're only talking about $192,000. And I also think that since we have started a capital reserve for the community college of $100,000, that we ought to do the same thing for the school system. And I know I only have one vote, but I know this, that I'm not going to vote in favor of a fiscal year budget that doesn't have some increase for our school system.
Mr. Chair, I think that we all realize how important our education is and how important our teachers are. And I think that this is not a lot to ask, that we add this to our budget to show our appreciation to what the hard work they do. We know that the county funds their paycheck, and we know that this isn't the thing the county, that the, I mean, this, the state funds the paycheck as far as raises and stuff. We notice that most of the counties do give supplements. We know that we do give one, but I don't think it would hurt us to add just a little bit more to it to show our appreciation for the hard work our educators do. So I would agree with you.
Mr. Chairman, I also totally agree that we need to support our schools, because that's the beginning of our foundation of our younger children up until they leave high school, college, whatever. So I don't, at this time, I feel like that we're able to do it, we should do it, we may not do it again, we don't know, but at least we show forth an effort of what we're trying to do for our, for beginners on up. So I totally support this suggestion of the increase for the school board.
Any other comments?
Mr. Chairman, you know, with the points you three make, I don't think there's anyone up here that disagrees with the points you made. But what the majority of this board apparently thought last week was that we were going to undertake an efficiency study of the school system, and at that time, when we received it back, to analyze that efficiency study, thinking that it's going to either tell us there's enough of money there and it needs to be reallotted, or that there's not enough of money there and we need to appropriate more money.
Yeah.
And I think we said several times in our last public meeting or work session that was public, numerous board members made it clear that they were certainly willing to do that at that time, if that's what the study showed. I'm not speaking for anyone but Commissioner Seven, but that's where it seemed to be that the board was, or a majority of the board. Certainly not an attempt to not fund additional funds to the school board or to the school system, because there's no one that disagrees with the statement that you put forward and the two ladies on the board of why we would want to do that. But on the other hand, in our budget message, it's interesting to me that we only show $1.1 million of growth in revenue next year. And if you analyze this budget, you'll understand that the $1.1 million all arrives from new techniques that have been brought by our staff, probably new ideas that came with our new county manager in the way we would do three things: tax collection, ambulance collection, and then of course one thing brought by the state. But when you've got and actually they're bringing in more money than the $1.1 million we show in growth, so we're really having a net loss next year in projected revenues. And that's the concern that I guess and I'll use the word conservative members of the board have, because we're actually somewhat losing revenue, and thank goodness we found ways to collect more of the revenue that's really due us. And anticipation 3 years out of what's going to happen to us under tax reval, there are some of us that are concerned, particularly with some parts of our county, maybe up in the Rocky Mountain area, of a depressed state of where our tax values are. And I'd much rather be prepared for that if it comes than to have obligated ourselves for future funding and then have to pull it all back in, because that's just dangerous, particularly when it's in inclination. And the most misunderstood thing is the supplement for our teachers, when this board really doesn't have anything to do with supplements. We don't fund, you know, we don't designate supplements. What we are charged with is to give the school board as much money as we can give them every year after we've fulfilled everyone else's obligation or in with the mix of everyone else's obligation. I certainly misspoke when I said after. That's not the way it works. It works. You look at the whole picture and you do as much as you can for everybody. But I think we would do a real injustice if we were to do a $4 million increase, raise the supplement 7%, and then in 2 or 3 years say, we can't do that anymore. People, rightfully so, budget themselves based on what they're making, and to try to pull salaries back, we had to do that some in the private enterprise in 7, 8, 9, and 10, and it's not a pretty picture to have to do that. I had to do it quite a bit myself in my own company. So that's why, you know, part of us are where we are. Certainly has nothing to do with education, the need for education, or the want to do all we can for education. But we must be very careful and diligent in the way we do that. And that's why we're getting this efficiency study done, is to allow us a better projection of where we are moving forward. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for allowing me to give that perspective.
Yeah. I don't disagree with your concerns. I just think that based on our projections that we're talking about $292,000 of what I had proposed, which is small.
190.
Yeah, but I also said $100,000 put in the capital reserve.
Right.
And
the difference.
And that's, to me, that's a small amount. At least it is putting something into the fiscal year budget. Getting them started.
Understood.
And after the study come back with whatever it shows, if it shows that we should put more, I agree that we should put more. That's my reason. And your concerns are well taken. Commissioner Outlaw?
I have received some input, not a great deal, quite frankly. But most of the input that I've got, I've received actually 8 emails total. And none of these emails, to the best of my knowledge, are from my district. I know 6 of them were from around Spring Hope, and one of them was from Parker School, and the other one I wasn't quite sure. But it just seems to me, as the father of an educator, that's not really funny, that's a fact, Mr. Franklin Lamb, that's a fact. I'm the father of an educator. And my son-in-law is an educator. My wife retired from the Nash Rocky Mount school system. I'm a product of the Nash County school system. I understand, and maybe as much as many others, what the challenges are facing our educators. I understand the monetary needs that they have. I have a grandson that has had a kidney transplant, and I supplement, my wife and I supplement our daughter and son-in-law's income significantly on a monthly basis to cover medical needs and just general household needs. And then to get these few emails that they don't say it outright, but they imply that I don't care about education. I just think that is totally ridiculous. What I care about is local funding, because I really have no authority over state and federal dollars. I care where local funding is going. And so I have, quite frankly, literally spent hours and hours in the budget that I've received from the Nash Rocky Mount school system. And I just, maybe I'm just not a smart guy, but it's very difficult to get to the information. But unless I'm sadly mistaken, if our objective, and it should be the objective of our school board, our county commissioners, our parents, our educators, everybody, to send as much money as we can to the classroom in an effort to reduce classroom size. I think most every educator I talk to would agree with that. But unless I'm sadly mistaken, in this budget that I just received, 721.5 teachers, none, zero teachers were funded locally. Now, if you go back 98, 99, 2000, and you look at local funding, and I've got all this information because I've researched it rather heavily, you will see a steady and consistent trend in funding coming away from the classroom and moving into administration. I do know that in this current budget, there are at least, from best I can figure, 14 directors funded locally. And I'm gonna just throw this out there. Again, I'm not the smartest guy in the world, but I have done the math and I've figured it as close as I can. And to the best of my understanding, and I may be way off base, but I can show anybody that wants to see it how I got it, the number I got at. I took the supplement line, I deducted what I believe is the superintendent's supplement, which is on a WRAL report. I deducted what the State Board of Education statistical profile says the supplement is for assistant principals, I'm sorry, assistant superintendents, and I left the rest of it for those directors. And that supplement for those 10 directors was over $11,000 each. That's just one example, and I can cite many other situations. So I want it to be known today, I've said it many times, I support education. And if I were sitting on the Nash Rocky Mount Board of Education, I would be eager to get this efficiency study completed, because if it is what you think it is, then that report will justify additional spending, and I will vote for that additional spending. I don't know at what amount, but I will vote for some additional spending, more than what Mr. Belfield has recommended, and I will vote for that to be retroactive back to the beginning of this budget year. I don't know what else I can do to justify my belief, strong belief, and support for the Nash Rocky Mount school system. If you think it is what it is, let's get that efficiency study done, get this out of the way, and then we can move on with it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
And thank you. Any other comments from commissioners?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I agree with Commissioner Outlaw in that this board totally supports Nash Rocky Mount school system. I support personally the teachers, the classrooms, the administrators, but I do have a priority to see that the money be spent in the classrooms and for the teachers as much as possible, and not on some of the other expenses that I see in the budget. So with that, I do, as I said last week in our work session, would still agree to wait till we get the results from the study before we make an increase in that budget.
Okay, yeah.
I agree with them in the we should, I think we should decide what they're going to do, what our findings warrant us to do at that time, and then whatever it needs to be done, add it to it or take it away. Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, the board has voted to have the study, and I'm sure we'll have that hopefully completed before this year's 2014 come to a conclusion, and we'll have some kind of recommendations coming out of that report. And I have said this in our meetings that we do need to concentrate on the classrooms. and so that our classroom sizes won't be up there 30 or more students in a class, because it can be handled better with smaller class size. In fact, I've had some teachers say that to me, that they prefer a smaller class size, somewhere around 22 or 23 kids, rather than having 29 and 30. And I agree with that, and we do need to. And I'll be saying this to the state legislators, because we will be having county legislative day Wednesday of next week, which is the 28th. And we'll probably be up there all day talking to legislators on concerns that the counties have about this legislative budget. Commissioner Webb, you have some other comment?
No, I was just going to say that we need a motion to.
Well, a motion for what?
Accept the budget as presented for till the June the 4th meeting.
June 2nd.
No, I was going to adjourn the recess meeting, and we'll reconvene on our regular meeting June the 2nd, in which we will have a public hearing. Okay. And I want to.
You need to call for the public hearing and vote to set up.
Do I need to do that today? Okay. All right. I entertain a motion for calling for a public hearing. And preferred date is June the 2nd.
So moved.
Moved by Commissioner Wells.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Outlaw. All in favor, and that's 10 o'clock. That's it. Okay, your motion. All in favor of the motion, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
Ayes have it. And we will, ladies and gentlemen, we will have a public hearing on the budget June the 2nd, and it will start at 10 o'clock. And you're free to come and make comments or recommendations that you individually have or collect as a group. Now I entertain a motion to adjourn the recess meeting. But
the budget meeting. Going to recess what? Tomorrow morning.
Yes.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, we got that workshop tomorrow. Thank you for reminding me.
That was my question.
thank you for reminding me. Motion to adjourn the recess meeting until tomorrow at,
10 a.m.
You're right, 10 a.m.
So moved.
Moved by Commissioner Outlaw.
Second.
Seconded by Commissioner Davis.
Clarify that. Motion to recess this meeting until tomorrow. You said
adjourn. That was the motion to
recess this meeting until tomorrow morning.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
That's it.
And that's the motion. All in favor of it, let it be known by saying aye.
Aye.
Ayes have it. We recess this meeting until tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, I mean, what's the difference? We put extra in there for them.